turn to you. Are you not the God of love who opened your ears to all? Listen to our prayers for your servant, Father Kevin, whom you called out of this world. Lead him to your kingdom of life and peace, and count him among the saints in glory. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and that perpetual light shine upon him. O God, come to our aid. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Skills and his gifts because he believed in the work of the foreigner. And as a student of the changing church of Vatican II, Father Kevin believed in ecumenism. I welcome representatives of church and faith communities from other places too. I welcome our diocesan bishop, Bishop Donald McCure, and our brother priests, religious men and women. But most warmly of all, I welcome you, the people of Drumquin, the people of Langfield Parish, and of all the faith communities in this Drumquin area, faith communities and perhaps none. Someone, a young person, showed me earlier today a Facebook page entitled Drumquin Through the Years. There was a photograph of Father Kevin's return to Drumquin yesterday evening, a symbolic photo taken by Jason McCartney. Father Kevin crossed and built many a bridge, they wrote on Facebook, in his life, and especially between the communities here in Drumquin throughout his 21 years of ministry in this area. It was Saturday, the coronation of King Charles, where he read a prayer asking to be a blessing to those of every faith and conviction. It was a beautiful prayer of inclusiveness. And if anyone made inclusiveness his mission, it was Father Kevin Mullan. So I'm glad that you're here to pray this ecumenical service this evening. Recently, in a New York Times article, he was described by the journalists as one of Oma's most revered figures, a Catholic priest who began building bridges to his Protestant counterparts. Tonight is a witness what he has done, and we are grateful for his work in our midst. This prayer, this evening, I believe, is a prayer of gratitude. And I'm sure in your hearts this evening, you have many words of gratitude for what Father Kevin has done. We will bring those prayers and those words of gratitude to our prayer this evening. We brought in his remains and we placed upon them the book of the scriptures. And the prayer this evening is made up of so many of the scriptures that he read, believed in, and practiced. We have a stool, a symbol of his ministry and priesthood. And now we light the Easter candle. The Easter candle we use as the symbol of Christ, the light of the world, in John's Gospel. We use it on special occasions, particularly on Holy Saturday night, when the candle is brought into a darkened church and all of the congregants light their candles from them. But first, we lit our candle from the Paschal candle on the day of our baptism, or at least our parents and our grandparents or our godparents did it for us. So, Sister Geraldine, I invite you to follow.
Merciful God, we light this candle as a sign of your love, a sign of light and hope in the darkness of death and loss. You have not made us for darkness and death, but for life with you forever. Without you, we have nothing to hope for. With you, we have nothing to fear. Speak to us now your words of eternal life. Set the light of your glory before us to guide our way and lift us to the peace of your presence. Who will separate us from the love of Christ?
Lord of light and life, bring healing and wholeness to those who are sick, and gather those who have died into your embrace. Guide those who are fearful and lost. Be a companion to us on our journey through life. May peace, hope, light, and new life come for all by knowing that nothing can separate us from your love. We make our prayer in the name of Jesus, our risen Lord. Amen.
Members of the Church's Forum will lead the psalms that we will pray this evening. As you look at your sheet, there are some of the verses printed in heavy dark type, and they are the verses that I invite you now to respond to. The leader will read what's in lighter type.
Courage, the victory is mine. I have conquered the world. Hallelujah. In the Lord, I have taken my refuge. How can you say to my soul, fly like a bird to its mountain? See, the Lord is in his holy temple, the Lord whose throne is in heaven. He looks down on the world. His gaze tests mortal men.
The Lord tests the dust of the grave. The Lord of heaven's gaze. He sets fire on your soul away. He sets scorching wind of their heart.
The Lord is just and loves justice. The upright shall see his face.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be. World without end. Amen. Courage, the victory is mine. I have conquered the world. Hallelujah.
He shall live in your tabernacle. He shall dwell on your holy mountain. Alleluia. Lord, who shall be admitted to your tent and dwell on your holy mountain?
He walks where I walked. He acts with justice and sees the truth in his heart. He knows the sound of the song.
He who does no wrong to his brother, who casts no slur on his neighbor, who holds the godless in disdain, but honors those who fear the Lord.
He leaves the flesh on the highway, he takes the wondrous on the low, and accepts no rights against sinners. Such a man will stand forever.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and Holy Spirit.
When I am lifted up above the earth, I shall draw all men to myself. Alleluia. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places. He destined us in love to be his sons through Jesus Christ, according to the purpose of his will, to the praise of his glorious grace, which he freely bestowed on us in the beloved. He has made known to us in all wisdom and insight the mystery of his will, according to his purpose, which he set forth in Christ.
His purpose he set forth in Christ, as a plan for the fullness of time, to unite all things in him, things in heaven and things on earth.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be.
A reading from the Gospel according to John.
Jesus showed himself again to the disciples. It was by the Sea of Tiberias, and it happened like this. Simon Peter, Thomas called the twin, and Nathanael from Cana in Galilee, the sons of Zebedee, and two more of his disciples were together. Simon Peter said, "I'm going fishing." And they replied, "We'll come with you." They went out and got into the boat, but caught nothing that night. It was light by now, and there stood Jesus on the shore, though the disciples did not realize that it was Jesus. Jesus called out, "Have you caught anything, friends?" And when they answered no, he said, "Throw the net out to starboard, and you'll find something." So they dropped the nets, and there were so many fish that they could not haul it in. The disciple Jesus loved said to Peter, "It is the Lord." At these words, "It is the Lord," Simon Peter, who had practically nothing on, wrapped his cloak around him and jumped into the water. The other disciples came on in the boat, towing the nets and the fish. They were only about 100 yards from land. As soon as they came ashore, they saw that there was some bread there and a charcoal fire with fish cooking on it. Jesus said, "Bring some of the fish you've just caught." Simon Peter went aboard and dragged the net to the shore full of big fish, 153 of them. And in spite of there being so many, the net was not broken. Jesus said to them, "Come and have breakfast." None of the disciples was bold enough to ask, "Who are you?" They knew quite well it was the Lord. Jesus then stepped forward, took the bread, and gave it to them, and saved the fish. This was the third time that Jesus showed himself to the disciples after rising from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
When we are called ashore, as we must, when our time on the sea of life comes to an end, and when you, Lord, call to us, "Have you caught anything, friends?" May we say, "We caught sight of you and heard your voice." And know that in all we do, our labours and vain without your word to guide and to encourage. May we also say, "We caught the faith that beckons us to a greater companionship, to have the gift of fellowship, of friendship, of working together in the knowledge of doing your will, to have that reliance amongst seafarers, battling against wind and current, of casting our nets into the unknown, trusting in your providence, to gain the recognition that others can teach us, to reassure what we inwardly know already of your presence and power. May we catch the glimpse of the early light that breaks through the dark morn and speaks to us of your inner light that fashions thought and spirit. May we be like Peter, eager and rushing to meet you, Lord, and alone afraid of the naked truth of sinfulness and guilt, and wanting to cloak our shame that impedes our swimming efforts. May we nevertheless catch that compelling love that urgently desires forgiveness in our hastening to you. And when we come ashore,
May our hall of good works be plentiful, the abundant harvest that comes from obeying your command and keeping faith. And although you do not need what we can offer, your desire made us grow in your love for the Lord, to do and to be. And when we see the breakfast that awaits on that celestial shore, may we be overjoyed in your abiding company, O Lord, and know at last your love completely, that guide us safely across the ever-changing currents of life. Have you caught anything, friends?
Yeah.
and set all humankind free. Risen Saviour, free us to live in newness of life as daughters and sons of God.
Risen Saviour, you walked with the disciples on the way to Emmaus and set their hearts on fire. Speak to our hearts and let us know that you are with us. King of the new creation, you are enthroned at God's right hand. Set our hearts on the things that are of heaven. Spread into the fullness of your truth.
That keep us from serving others. Community and all whom he served throughout his ministry. May they experience the consolation and support of God's loving presence.
Of your love for us. May all peoples of the earth receive the good news of your gospel. As your people, we ask this evening for the power to live in the joy of your rising. May we sing with all creation, "Hail, O light of Christ, welcome, risen Lord."
Grant, Lord, we pray, that as our faith is built on the risen Christ, so too our hope may be steadfast as we await the resurrection of all the faithful departed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Community would like you to gather for refreshments in the parish hall. So
you.